here at Snaizeholme Woodland Trust, we own and manage about 561 hectares here. And our aim here is nature recovery. And so we've got a range of habitats. We have upland blanket bog, we have areas of limestone pavement and shallow soils on top of limestone. We have these riverside meadows that you see behind me today. And we have some of the steeper slopes that we're looking at tree planting on. So we've had a range of habitats that we're looking at really managing them in a real blended way to bring them all together. The Woodland Creation Area is one of the bigger parts of the project, so we have about 290 hectares where we're looking at establishing woodland on, mainly on steeper slopes in behind me, leaving this sort of valley bottom largely open. We're doing it slightly differently, so we're not using any single-use plastics here in terms of tree guards, and we're planting more trees than what we want to see succeed, so we're actually accepting a lot of losses, and we hope that will create a real natural woodland. I've seen a lot of woodland creation in this area, which has relied on tree guards for their protection. And like I say, give it 5 years when the stake rots and the high winds we get up in these sort of elevations, you just end up with the trees lying flat before long, and then obviously less resilient when the tube does come off. Whereas these guys, you know, growing out here on their own from day one, they'll hopefully be much more resilient. But
yeah, they'll be more like the trees over there.
Yeah, and what you'd maybe expect to have here naturally anyway. So yeah. Good start, just got to keep them going. Yes, here at Snaizeholme, we're at the head of the York catchment, and all the water you see here today eventually ends up out towards York. And York in recent times had a lot of issues with flooding, and also a lot of the communities on the way to York as well. So we see a lot of what our interventions and our activity here all relates to water in some way, really. But we have the peatland up on the top where we just finished a round of restoration work on. And all that work is looking at sort of slowing the flow of the water coming off that bit of land, blocking up drainage ditches and the like. So that's great for the habitat, but the knock-on benefit is that it takes a lot longer for the water to come off that land. We also have more direct intervention in the watercourses themselves that we've undertaken recently, and we have more planned in the next couple of years. And that's looking, again, it's really focused on improving the habitats, but the knock-on advantage is that holding that water back. We also then have the trees, which have a lot of positive benefits around water retention as well. It makes the ground a lot rougher, it increases the infiltration beads, and yeah, a lot of good stuff on that front as well. Predominantly this land was sheep grazed. We have actually removed sheep from the majority of the land now. We have brought in native breed Herefords, a herd of Herefords that we do have here. So that we are still farming and grazing this landscape, but in a much different way. Our expectation is, and the understanding is, that we have much rougher vegetation now as a result. And again, for water, that's a great thing for the interception of that water.
FSC provides a system called Verified Impact, so it goes above and beyond forest management certification to provide those ecosystem services that are intangible but are intrinsic to our health and well-being. It looks at carbon, water, biodiversity, soil and recreation, and we've also introduced air quality and cultural services. The research and the evidence that they provide is independently audited by an FSC accredited certification system to show that they are bringing all of those ecosystem services to the fore. All of the Woodland Trust land is FSC certified for forest management. So we worked with them to look at what they wanted to do at Snaizeholme and how this could help, and also how it could attract sponsorship. They have been working with Essity, who is a very large healthcare and hygiene provider. They are intrinsically dependent on water for their services. They wanted to help a project by providing funding to help improve water quality and reduce flood risk in an area not too far from where they work. And we introduced them to Snaizeholme. They were very keen on the project and what the outcomes were, and the fact that there's going to be so much data and evidence of what they are achieving out of this. Essity provided a donation to help move this project forward, and in return what Essity see is real on the ground benefit. FSC Verified Impact is very good for potential sponsors who want to go above and beyond. It helps with their brand image, it helps tell a story to their customers or their clients about what they're doing, mitigating those impacts that they might not be able to mitigate in any other way. UK woodlands have been historically cut down, so we are one of the most deforested areas in the world. But with the help of Verified Impact and good forestry management, such as that practiced by the Woodland Trust, we can change this so that we can improve, as Snaizeholme is doing, the cover of forestry across the UK and all of those intangible benefits that they provide.
Yeah, I think this area, we planted this sort of one of the first areas we planted about 3 years ago now, and it's really starting to show what we're trying to achieve here. So it's sort of patchy woodland. In some places we've got quite a lot of trees that are succeeding and some that have failed, and we've got this sort of open structure, and we're doing quite well with the species mix here, even though we just left them and not necessarily beat them up. They've sort of got quite a nice mix through. We do have Scots pine in as well, and that's one of the only broadleaf species that we don't have. So the vast majority of our work at Snaizeholme is funded through the White Rose Forest, and we're really grateful to have the opportunity that we can cover costs of research. And so we're really excited to monitor what the response is to our interventions here. I think it's really important for us to understand going forward into advocacy and what we do and how we manage our woodlands going forward. The main angle on the research is looking at what the impact of our tree planting is having on this landscape. So it's looking at things like water, so how the water is coming off the land over time. Also looking at the changes in vegetation as a response to the tree cover, and also the soils, what's happening underground. So there's a lot of really interesting work underway. And then this led quite nicely into the ecosystem services, working with FSC and the partnership that how we have with Essity. We're doing that research as part of the project, but it feeds straight into being able to verify what it is that we are achieving here. Yeah, so not just the trees getting up, but just the reduction in the grazing here. Like, see such a difference in the ground vegetation already. You know, quite a lot of wildfires coming back, got some speed wells in clusters up here, which just wouldn't have been here when the sheep were still here.